to read from verses number 1. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Before maybe we begin reading, allow me to welcome our sister, Sister Sophie. Down, you just stand, please. Wow, shall we just put our hands together? Blessed to have you around. Please may you be blessed and be encouraged. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody say what? Say, we love you, sister.
We love you, sister.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much. All right. John chapter number 1. Hello. Hey, chichi. Hello. Baby boy. Now listen to me, okay? Yeah. Okay, good boy. All right, John chapter number 1, we are going to read from verses number 1. Please, I would like each one of us to pay extra attention. Amen? It is very important. Please, if possible, go and read through again. From the word of the Lord, from verses number 1, John chapter number 1, verses number 1. In the beginning, the Word already existed. The Word was with God. And the Word was God. Every time that you read the Word, you are reading about God. If you want to know God, mulefu kushwalesa, mukwate umute uwa kuberenga ichevo. Pantu kunte ndekelo kwa ichevo, kabili chevo chali na lesa, kabili chevo ni lesa. So, idiyo nse mwle mfwe chevo, ni nshimule mfwa kuli lesa. Ichevo, lusa nikolo wa makasa Yesu mwono tuatila mfwe. If you want to be effective Christian, you must be ready to hear the word of God. And you not only hear, but you must follow the word of God. It reminds me, when Joshua was called, Joshua was called by God, and he was told to say, my son Moses has died. Now you, Joshua, take up this challenge. Prepare these people and cross River Jordan. Pay attention to the word. Meditate upon it day and night, and not swerve from it to the left nor the right, so that it may go well with you. So when we hear the word, we are hearing about God speaking to us so that it may go well with you. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
If you want things to go well with you, love the word of God. The more you love the word of God, that is how much you love God himself. That is how much you love God himself. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
So we must love the word of God. Don't forget. We'll be building up on this as we go. We'll be building on this. So now, from the very beginning, the Word was with God. Through Him, God made all things, including you. Madam Fongwe.
Let's
up and get into fiance. Fiance. Okurunda kuna ifwebe. Because we have been made by God. So through him, all things were made by God. And no, without him, nothing was there. So it is all about God. So through him, God made all things. Not one thing in all creation was made without him. Through his creation, all things were made by him. You must know that you have been made by God. And there is the reason why God made you. You are not just there for nothing. You are there for a reason. You are there for a purpose. And you must understand who created you. Then you'll be able to follow him very well. Without so, it's very hard. It is very impossible. Hallelujah, son.
So, the word in verses 4, the word was the source of life. Ichebo entendekelo yabu miwesu. Ichebo. That's why, when you lack the word of God, make this one, please sit there. Hello? Uye kamiya. Baby, come here. Hello, baby, sit there. Look there, sit there. All right, thank you. So, you see what I was saying? Achieve. In verses number 4, please. The word was the source. When they are using the word source, intendekelo, iyabumi, ichebo. Ichebo na tumfoka kwa chini lesa. You ever been? So lesa, entendekelo, iyabumi, weno umwa kwa taini. Ukwa kula lesa, uvu mimona inita tuinga kuacha. Because the source of your life is God. That's why you should love the word of God. Hallelujah, Sam.
Amen.
Let's just talk about the word. Before we go further, let's just end with verses number 4. When you love the word of God, that is how much you love God. Because the same way is the source of your life. The word of the Lord is the source of what? Of your life. Without the word of God, your life is jumbled. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
Tufile tu wabika kwa mano, uchebo. Pantu kwa ulechebo, ninshumu mwesu. Kula wabuwa furungana, kula wabuwa salangana. It's not in order. Umu mwesu kula luvana. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
Are we together?
Amen.
Umu mwesu kula uchebo chakwa lesa, kula luvana. That's why you and me, we must pay extra attention to his way. We must pay extra attention to his way. Not only today, not only tomorrow, but for the rest of our lives. If you want things to go well with you, love the word of God. And don't just love the word of God, but do what the word of God says. That it may go well with you. If the word of God tells you to say, do not do this or that, don't do it. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
If the word of God says, pray for one another, you must pray for one another. Help me, somebody. Say, neighbor.
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 You can't make it.
You can't make it.
Without his way.
Without his
way.
Come
together.
Amen.
Tetutwanishe. We are going nowhere without his way. That's why we must love the word of God. And how much we love the word of God, that's how much we love God himself. And who is this God? Who is this word? The word is God. And the word is the source of our lives. It's the beginning of our downfall. No matter how much we may look, without the word, we are going nowhere. If you want things to go well with you, love the word. And that is how much you love the word. That's how much you love God. Amen, somebody. You know, if there's something that we should raise about, we should raise a prayer point to say, Mwele san sambirishe nukusa ukute mweche uche. Pantukute mweche uche akwalesa, ekute mwalesa. Nsambirishe nukusa nchenji, ukusa mbirila ukute mweche uche. Ichebo chakwalesa, tachakarufio mtu na mlao. But the moment you neglect the word of God, then you are going away. Let me bring you to another scripture. John chapter number 15. Hallelujah. John chapter number 15. We are going to read verses number 5. The Bible says with me, I am the vine and you are the branches. Inendi chimuti, elo imomuri misambo. Those who remain in me and I in them,
we will bear much fruit. For you can do nothing without me. Bale mpamba. Ukwabula lesa bantu Yesu Kristu anati ine ndishinde imomuni misambo. Echo imomuni kale muli ine na ine muli imwe elo mukakwate fisabo ifingi. Ukwabula ine ne Yesu tapale fi umuntu enga chita. That is how much you should know. Ukwabula Yesu Kristu imwe na ine ni tapale ko fileya. Tapale ko tuinga kwani tapale ko tuinga chita because the owner of the source of life is not there with us. We'll be there cheating ourselves, no matter what we do, no matter how much efforts we make, to allow the famopen, because the source of life is not there with us. What is your position today? How are you leading your life today? How am I leading my life today? Do I love the word of God? Hallelujah, something. Now, you also must understand something here. Jesus Christ is saying, abide in me and I in you, so that you can be much fruitful. Because apart from me, you can do nothing. Meaning that hearing the word of God is one thing, and doing or acting on what the word of God tells us is another thing. When we read in the book of James chapter number 1 and verses 22, it says, do not just be hearers of the word and so deceive yourselves, but do what it says. Atumulamu fafye chebo, no kulaive pa mwebe ne. Lelo mule chita echo mumfuile. So ukumfwa is another thing, and doing is another thing. Kuti mwa umfwa pata mchitile. It will not help you. Because now mumfwa pata mchitile echo mumfuile. Hallelujah, Sam. So teku mfwafye kweka, but kuchite echo mumfuile. That's how it went. And that is how it goes. The word of God is about obedience. Without obedience, you cannot make it.
Amen.
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 Amen. So, without faith, the little faith is there. Umuntu umfuazye lero talexefia le fia lingiro kuchefia umfuire Bible lela ndaji aba kwati mulole lolo shabuni mila amune fia lemonika amune fia lemonika yapo pali mila ala ba fia lemonika efia bo muntu umfuechebo lero talexefia umfuire.
That is not your portion.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
Let us learn to hear and do what we have heard.
Yeah.
Because you find it in the book of James, chapter number 1, verses number 22. Maybe the last scripture. The last scripture I want us to read again in John, chapter number 8. We'll read it from verses number 31. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
Are we there?
Yeah.
John, chapter number 8, and verses number 31. 31 says, so Jesus said to those who believe in him. Remember, he's talking about those that have believed in him. Talelanda kuba ndoba shamu sumina aa. Kuli awo aba musumina. Bale mfongwa.
Amen.
Ili ngiri na tumarekwa java shamu sumina, eba shayishivalesa. Na ngweba funukula mfwechevo. Leesu Kristu alelanda kuba sumina. Alelanda kuli imwena yefweba ni mulukuta. He's not talking about the people that are outside. But he's talking about you and me.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
Are we with me?
Jesus Christ at this point is not talking to the people outside. He's talking to people that are believers. He's talking to people that call themselves the Christians. He's talking to people that are saying, we are Christians. We are believers. We are followers of Jesus Christ. He's talking to you and me. Now listen to what he said. He says, if you obey, if you obey, other version says, if you abide, ngamwabela ukusambilisha kwandi. Bale mpongwa. Diena chine chine imwe nishimiliwa sambi bandi. Na muli my disciples bandi. If you obey my teachings, then you are truly my disciple. If you obey, not if you hear, if you obey. Because you might hear, but you don't obey. Kuti mwa umfwa, leluta mwle konga ife umufu. Kacha miyafu.
Nomba Yesu alena ndati ngachakuchira mwaumvu echebo chandi. Nwakonke fonde misambirisha nishchine chine mumuri bena Kristu abafika. Kwati babena Kristu because kuti Yesu alande it means kwati babena Kristu amo abaumvu abata bachitefe umvu. You might be here, you hear, but you cannot do what you are hearing. It will not help you. Because Jesus Christ here was saying, if you truly obey my teachings, if you follow my teachings, if you do my teachings, then you are truly my disciples. You are Christians genuinely. So you must do what you hear. You must do the teachings of Jesus Christ and do them, obey. The Bible says obedience is better than sacrifice. You can sacrifice, you can bring a lot of offerings here, you can bring a lot of gifts here, you can bring whatever you may have here, but if you don't obey, it does not pay you anything. Amen. It's not how much you bring here that will make you a genuine Christian, but it's how much you obey his word. Do you obey his word? I'm not saying you obey me, but you obey his word. Because it's not about me, but it's about Jesus Christ. So that it may go well with you, brother, with you, my sister. Coming to church is one thing. But doing what we hear from church is another thing. You must bear that in your mind. Hallelujah, somebody. Amen. Ukwisa kuchechi chintu chimwanangu chintu chisuma lero kwa ngeko tulesa mbila kuchechi na chena chintu chimbi ichi chirine pa kuisa ke kuchechi. What does it pay you? What does it give or profit any one of us? We come to church, we hear the word of God, but we don't do what it says.
May God help us.
Hallelujah, Santa.
Amen.
Children of God, it's not about you will get you. It's about hearing. When you hear and do what it says, that's all. It changes us automatically. We are transformed automatically. We don't need even to push one another. It's about what? Obedience. Obeying his way. That's why he's saying, if you obey my teachings, then you are truly my disciples. These are the words coming from Jesus Christ. And he goes on further to say, then you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. If you want to be free in your life, obey the teachings of the Lord Jesus Christ. Then you'll be free. If you want things to go well with you, obey the teachings of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. It is very important to be obedient to his teachings. When it comes to our Lord Jesus Christ, please let's bring ourselves down. And pay attention, be obedient to his way. Because the way is the source of your life. Meaning that the way is the source of your good life. The way is the source of your business, is the source of your work, is the source of your career. Whatsoever for things to go well with you, you need the word of God. You need the word of God. Desire, love the word of God, that it may go with you, because it is the way which is the source of your life. Hallelujah. Are we with me?
Amen.
Very important. We must love his way. We must love his way. So everywhere when we come to church, let's pay attention. That will help us to change. That will help us to grow. That will help us to move from one glory to the other glory. From one level of glory to another. It is from his word. Now, when we neglect his word, we neglect ourselves. Because he says, apart from me, you can do nothing. So please, please, let's not cheat ourselves. It is about obedience to his word. That's why Joshua was taught to say, meditate upon this word day and night, that it may go well with you. When you neglect the word of God, so if you want things to go well with you in your life, in your career, in our work, in our marriage, in our business, and so on, let us love his way. Because the way is the source of our life. May God bless His word this morning.